After its debut as weightlifting in the Tokyo 1964 Paralympic Games, the sport, now known as powerlifting, expanded from just male lifters with a spinal cord injury to include athletes with physical impairments that affect their lower limbs or hips, or athletes with short stature. Female powerlifters made their Paralympic debut in 2000. Powerlifting is the ultimate test of upper body strength, and you'll often see athletes lifting more than three times their own body weight. Powerlifters are split into 10 different categories based on body weight for each gender. Powerlifting consists of one discipline, a bench press. Unlike the able-bodied sport where athletes use their feet on the floor to assist the bench press, Paralympic athletes lie totally flat on a completely different style of bench. Each competitor has 2 minutes to complete their attempt. When the lifter has the bar under full control, they must wait until they receive the command, start.
Start!
Then they have to lower the bar in a controlled manner and definitively stop it on the chest. Next, they press it upwards, lock out both elbows simultaneously and hold the bar under control until the referees command to wrap. At least two white lights are required from three referees for a good lift. A red light indicates a bad lift. Athletes have three attempts, and the winner is the athlete that lifts the heaviest weight. In the third round, two weight changes are permitted. The weight change can be higher or lower. No changes are allowed if the lifter has already been called to the platform by the speaker, and or if the bar has already been loaded. To attempt a new record, it must exceed the previous one set by a minimum of 0.5 kilograms. Where a world record is broken during the actual three lifts of competition, the 0.5 kilograms does not count towards the competition total, but is rounded down to the full kilogram. The jury may allow a fourth attempt for a world record. This adds suspense to the competition, as a lifter could break the world record but may not win gold. Powerlifting offers a tense and dramatic spectacle where coaches have to be good strategists as their athletes battle to outlift their rivals.
Para powerlifting is all about the bench press. It's about the strongest people on the planet going head to head. Once positioned on the bench, an athlete must perform the lift after being given the start signal. The athlete lowers the bar to the chest and must hold the weight motionless. Both elbows must extend at the same rate and lock out together. Once the lift has been completed, they will receive a rack signal and return the bar to the rack. An immediate decision will be made by the referees as to whether the lift was successful or not. A white light is given for a successful lift, and a red light signifies an unsuccessful lift. Athletes may make three lifts during the competition and must increase the weight attempted by at least 1 kilogram following a successful lift. The winner is the athlete who lifts the most weight in their body weight category. In para powerlifting, athletes are classified by body weight alone, which means athletes with different impairments compete for the same medals. There are 10 different weight categories for both men and women. The body weight categories range from 49 kilograms to over 107 kilograms for men and 41 kilograms to over 86 kilograms for women. An incredible feat of strength, by using just their upper body, athletes can often lift more than three times their own body weight. If you'd like to find out more about para powerlifting, you can visit our website, where you'll find lots of information about the sport and how you can get involved.
Welcome back to the Wind Shore Forum for the final session of day one, and we're underway in the men's up to 54 kilogram category. Making the way to the floor from Kazakhstan is Zakhar Bumov. 100 kilograms is on the bar. A rack height of 14 for the first lift here. If he lifts this, this will equal his highest lift in last year's World Cup competition here in February 2020. It's a good lift, two white lights, one red. And Bumov from Kazakhstan gets up and running. 100 kilograms lifted, that equals his best from last year. He'll be looking to extend that over the first of the three lifts. And he's set the competition alive here in the final session. Five competitors competing. And next we have a British interest here in young Thomas Smith.
So Bumov successful with his first lift of 100. Thomas Smith,
please welcome for their first attempt.
115 on the bar. Here comes Thomas Smith. Plenty of support, I'm sure, watching this live stream. Thomas Smith from Huntington. Plenty of people, I'm sure, from Cambridge Regional College cheering him on. If you are, make sure you use that hashtag powerlifting. Let everyone know you're supporting Tom. Of qualifying Paralympic Games 2024 here with 115. Looks very smooth and a good lift. Three white lights, all three in agreement. It's a good lift, and Thomas Smith starts the competition at 115 with a successful lift.
So Thomas Smith competed last year, but he was in the up to 49 category, lifting 97 kilos. So he's moved up a weight category and also on the heavier weights. Next to go, the bar being raised to 138 kilograms. Mitsunori Ishikawa will be coming out very shortly for his first lift. Competed here last year at the same weight at 138, was not successful on his three attempts on that weight, so we're looking to amend that here today with a year more experience under his belt. Only took up powerlifting back in 2018 from the powerhouse Tsukuba in Japan. Looking to get at least two white lights, would love three on this first lift here as he settles himself down for 138 on the bar.
One minute.
Coward getting himself settled. Still 40 seconds left on the clock. 1:38. Nice and smooth, but not quite there. Two red lights there. So as you hear there, the announcement by Stephen Jameson, it was on the press sequence given against Ishikawa. So his first lift here in 2021 matches the same as 2020 on 1:38. Unfortunately, it's a no lift. He'll be back shortly as he looks to make amends there. That's the first of the three lifts so far. Two more athletes to go.
Yeah, next athlete will be Panashuk from the Ukraine. Bar just being adjusted. And also added weight 147 is going to be the opening try of Panashuk. Here comes Pinesha. Competed in Mexico back in 2017 at the World Cup, reaching the final. Based in Dubai, representing Ukraine, who had a successful day one. 1:47. And a good lift. And a delighted Panashuk.
I like that one, Nikoski.
Big shout of yes.
Fantastic from the Ukrainian, 147 kgs.
And he starts the competition 1:40, and he's delighted with his opening lift and moves into first place.
One more lifter to go in this up to 54 category. But lift number one, Axel Bourlon from France, will be coming out to lift 1:57. Again, he was here this time last year. Another also not getting the successful lifts.
Please welcome for their first attempt from France, Axel Bourlon.
Last year he was lifting 160 and 165 as his target. And with 1:57 today for his first lift. Made his international debut back in 2018. In that debut year, he won the silver medal in the 2018 European Championships over in France. But he suffered a bit of an injury in 19, which put him on a bit of a backtrack, so he's coming back into his full health now. 1:57 on the bar. Three white lights is a good lift. So gets on the board there with 1:57. Goes straight to the top of the leaderboard. Straight away he goes to the top there, making his way up. We'll see what his second lift's going to be. Alex Boulam now gets that green marker on the board at 1:57.
Cracking lift there by the French athlete, 1:57. making amends for making a bit of a mess last year. Registering a valid lift and straight to the top of the pile in this up to 54 kilogram men's category. Zakhar Bumyov, who along with Thomas Smith competing in the juniors and also in the senior, where he's currently in fourth place. Successful lift in the first round of 100 kilograms, and Bumyov up to 105. Was successful last year in Manchester with a lift of 100, so this to go better than last year. Too sure whether Bumyov will trouble Thomas Smith, very much doubt it, but here he goes. It's a smooth lift and gets the all clear from two of the three judges. Just a question on the press sequence from one, but two out of three ain't bad, and gets a good lift. Two from two from Bumyov, as next will be Thomas Smith, looking to go in turn five more than his first lift of 115. 120 being loaded.
So Thomas Smith sitting in third place after the first rotation. It's 120. He's just set on the bar now. A lot of home support here last year for him, as well as online, as he addresses each of the referees. Already shown the improvements in another year's worth of performance. Smith currently in third place. Have to extend his performance here, so from 115 to 120 here for his second lift. Nice, back on the rack there. Down and up. And he gets the full three white lights there. Perfect lifting from Thomas Smith. Two from two here, 120 now. On the board, he stays in third place. Three white lights there. Lovely, lovely lift from the young Brit. So he stays in third place and in first place in the junior competition. Next we go up to 152. Ukrainian is the next lift to go in this up to 54 kilogram category.
It will be Ishikawa next. One 38 missed out in round one. So second attempt at 138. Ishikawa. Now at the moment, Thomas Smith, as we know, in third place. Ishikawa, if failing with this second attempt at 138, will have only one more lift at 138. If he is successful, will be the bronze medalist at least here. But as we know from last year in Manchester, athletes can miss out on all three. what happened with Axel Bourlon, who made amends with a 1.57 lift and is top of the tree this year at the moment. So Ishikawa, take two at 1.38. Again, very deliberate setup. 20 seconds left. Ishikawa. Looks good from this position. And gets a good lift from the judges. Two out of three. Give him the... And Ishikawa lifts at 1.38, moves into third place. And is more than likely going to stay in that third place in this competition. Thomas Smith then down into fourth in the senior competition, with Buminov in fifth. The top two, though. Panashuk of the Ukraine, 1.52 to be loaded, with Bulan looking at 1.67. So an outside chance for the Ukrainian of possibly catching Bulon. He'll need to lift this 1.52. But Mishikawa successful at 1.38 and secure with the bronze.
He'll be pleased to get that green marker on his name there after four in a row here. Here we go. Nesvik from Ukraine. Everybody have been on the medal table so far. He's got in at 1.47. The 2019 World Championships, placed 6th in the 54 category. Began in 2014 in his local club in the Ukraine, and made his debut in 2017 at the World Cup in Mexico City. Here vying for a spot in the Paralympics in Tokyo later this year. So 1.52 on the bar, up 5 kilos from his first successful lift. 1 minute. Shakes his head as he comes up. He knew that wasn't the right way. Three red lights. So not happy with the press sequence himself. And the referees agree with as he makes his way off there. He'll be coming back for his third lift. So one successful lift at the minute at 1.47. And he'll come back out for his third lift very shortly, as Axel Bourlon will be next to come on, leading the table at the minute at 1.57. He's lifted up another 10 kilos.
Yeah, 1.67 by those out in the middle, making sure everything's nice and secure. Also sanitized as well. There's Axel. 1.67. Pretty much guaranteed the gold. Axel Bourlon will looking to lift more than the 1.57 in round one. Friday, an insurance broker in Rouen, France. Axel Bourlon. At 1.67. No lift.
2-1 decision against Axel Bourlon there, two on the press sequence. He was close.
press sequence by two of the judges. And Axel Boulon unsuccessful with his first attempt at 167. He'll be back. We'll see whether 167 is the chosen weight for his final attempt as we start the final round of lifts. Zakir Brumanov, 100, 105, now up to 110 as we enter the third and final round.
Zakir Brumanov from Kazakhstan will be next to go. As we see the results so far, Boulan at the top at 157. Misuik, 147 in second place. And in third place currently, it's Ichikawa with 138. And here comes Brumanov competing in both the senior and the junior competition. He's in second place in the junior competition, 110 on the bar now. Added through his parents as well to take the sport up. No lift there. Chest sequence and press sequence there, causing the referees not to give him three white lights, two against one, closing him off. So Zakhar Brumanov stays in second place in the junior competition and in fifth place in the senior competition with his second lift, which was the successful one at 105. So next to go, we'll be loading the bar to 125 for Thomas Smith and his final lift.
Hey, Tom Smith, maybe the gold medalist in the junior competition, beating Brumanov. But Smith increased by 5 kilograms from 115 to 120. Successful at both. Now 125 the target. From the young man from Huntington. 125. We'll finish fourth in the senior competition. Well ahead of last year, where Thomas Smith lifted 97, so the progression is there for all to see, up to 120 here, 125. Big shout from his coach. And a good lift, a delighted Thomas Smith. Double fist pump on the bench. And Thomas Smith successful with all three. So 115, 120, and 125. Thomas Smith. A very successful championships here in Manchester. 125. He lifts in round three. Will finish fourth in the senior competition and takes gold in the juniors.
Next up, the bar's going to 143. From Japan, it's Mitsunori Ishikawa for his third and final lift. He was successful on lift number two at 138. This is now 143, so he's guaranteed the bronze medal. And part of this World Cup, the five stops, looking for the top eight in each of the bodyweight categories, with 20 medals up for grabs in Tokyo later this year. Shikara increasing his lift weight by 5 kilograms for this final lift here. So Lopez and coach primed ready to help him with his setup. Plenty of time left on the clock for his preparations. 1:43, final lift. So three red lights there.
All three green lights lighting up on the press. The
bar just going off balance slightly with the left hand, dropping down slightly, and also on the chest sequence. So he remains at 138 in his second round. So gold, a bronze medalist here in Manchester for Mitsunori Ishikawa. As he makes his way out of the arena there with a bronze medal. So now it's the final two lifts. And the bar weight is going up to 152. Panasiuk coming on for Ukraine very shortly.
Yeah, regarding the loaders, have worked very hard all day, making sure everything is safe and secure. Kazakhstan, I was in the World Championships 2019.
No lift.
And no lift signified by the judges for Panasiuk. So he will remain on 147, his first round lift, and finish second here in Manchester. So silver for the Ukrainian. As we await the final lift of the competition today, and it will be by the gold medalist in the up to 54 kilogram category, Axel Brulon of France, guaranteed gold and going again at 167.
So the loaders loading up to the red 25s. Well, the blue 20s, and also one of the green 1 kilos on each side, ready for 167, and then sanitizing as they have done all day.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome their third and final.
A secure environment with all the athletes taking part in their kit checks and weigh-ins over at the hotel about a mile away from here, and then coming out for their warm-up and onto the venue. Here comes the gold medalist then. He already has that in the bag for his first lift of 157. He's looking now to extend that to another 10 kilos here at 167. Highest win so far was silver in the European Championships on the year he made his debut. Now he's got a gold medal to his name in the Para Powerlifting World Cup competition. Can he put the 167 weight next to that medal. So right arm just dropping down on the way up there, so two red lights. Give it as a no lift there, but he still takes away the gold medal with that first lift of 157. The Frenchman Alex Bourland takes gold here in Manchester. There's a quick check on the screen as he makes his way down. He knows he's got it in his locker, couldn't quite get the arms working together on that one for 167. So France take gold, Ukraine silver, and Japan bronze in the senior competition. And in the junior competition, Thomas Smith from Great Britain taking the gold medal at 125, the only one of the three of the five athletes to complete all three successful lifts, with Zakhar Bumov from Kazakhstan taking silver in the junior competition. As you see there on the screen are the final results of the men's senior up to 54 kilogram category. Some absentee names and things, so British Ali Jawad not able to compete today, but there are still other opportunities in the World Cup competition coming up later in May over in Bangkok. Then they go to Tbilisi in Georgia, and then the final event in 19th to 26th of June is over in Dubai before all the results come in, and then the 22nd is when the Paralympics kicks off in Tokyo.
Yes, the road to Tokyo is what we are on at the moment. Competition over in Colombia, just over a fortnight ago. And now leg two here in Manchester. What a great day, great opening day to this four-day event. We've seen British world records.
Yeah, Olivia Broome early on setting the pace, wasn't she? Smashing her own British record by 3 kilograms to 100 kilograms.
Yeah, the real highlight was the women's up to 55 category. Mariana Shevchuk with a tremendous lift and a new world record. A real highlight of day one. Just waiting for the two medal ceremonies then to round off day one. The junior 54 and then the senior men's up to 54. Medal ceremony then for the junior up to 54 kilogram category, and the gold medal goes to Thomas Smith of Great Britain.
Let's hear it for your junior gold medalist, Thomas Smith.
Junior gold medalist Thomas Smith. And now the medal ceremony for the men's senior up to 54 kilogram.
This is the final ceremony, final action of today's competition here on day one of the World Para Powerlifting World Cup here at the Wythershaw Forum in Manchester. So the athletes making their way out now in front of the podium for the men's up to 54 kilogram category. Ichikawa completing his second lift as a successful lift of 138 kilograms.
Winner of the silver medal representing Ukraine, Kostyantin Panasiuk.
Panasiuk there with a 147 lift as his first lift. A really good, solid first performance. Just missing out on his 152. Axel Boulon there also with his first lift as the successful lift as 157, taking the gold medal here in the World Cup in Manchester. So medals being presented there, and a gold medal going to Axel Boulan from France on 157 kilograms as the athletes depart. The final action of day one here at the Wythershaw Forum, the World Para Powerlifting World Cup. So we're going to be back again tomorrow for more competition, 11 a.m. is the first event there. Hopefully more British records and more world records.
British records, world records, fantastic lifts, plenty of drama ahead of us. Three more days. We'll be back 11 o'clock in the morning here in Manchester, and we hope that you can join us on the live. We'll be back tomorrow. We'll see you there.